something that is good. And as alhamdulillah, sometimes we got to aid and clarify certain things, you know, saying to the musallin. Let's say raising the voice in the salah, making the takbir loud. This is maybe something that you want to convince yourself of. Or because of you basing upon something that you have no clarity about that. Right? But if, alhamdulillah, for those who study, you will not find them do the likes of these things. Because of they know that everything in this religion is based on what? It is haram until that you have a proof for it. So, ما دام أنك لا تكن عندك دليل فالترك أولى به. That to abandon it is first. Until you have the adilla for, you know, saying this or saying that or doing this or doing that. But if the person doesn't have no evidence for this, and the evidence is not that because you think it's the evidence for it, but it is the evidence because the scholars of hadith, the scholars of fiqh, or the scholars of usuluddin, they have mentioned that this is the evidence for this. Right? Meaning, he say, لا تسلط العقل على دين الله. Do not subject your intellect to the deen of Allah. Do not subject your intellect to the deen of Allah. Meaning you're going to put your aql first. He say, وَلَا تُصَلِّدْ هَوَىٰ. And do not place your desires first. وَإِنَّمَا هُوَ الْإِتِّبَاعُ وَتَرْكُ الْهَوَىٰ. But rather it is that a person, he will follow the text and not follow his desires. And he say, وَتَجْرِدُ اللَّهَ رَبُّ الْعَالَمِينَ. And he submit to Allah, the Lord of the creation. He submit to Allah, the Lord of the creation. And this, alhamdulillah, was the end point of this aspect that we just covered. For our next sitting, inshallah ta'ala, we'll be reading in regard to الْإِيمَانُ بِالْقَدَرِ خَيْرِهِ وَشَرِّهِ. Believing in the predestination. Believing in the predestination, the good and the bad. And alhamdulillah, this is a good revision for us after studying the hadith of Jibreel. After studying the hadith of Jibreel, where the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he was asked by Jibreel alayhi salatu wa sallam, what is al-Iman? Inform me of al-Iman. He said, al-Iman is that you believe in Allah, believe in the angels, the books, the messengers, the last day, and believe in the divine decree, the good and the bad. So the tartib here is very important to follow. Right? This sequence, believing in Allah first, believing in the malaika second, believing in the books, believing in the prophets, believing in the last day, and believing in the qadar, khayrihi wa sharrihi. The sequence is very important. لماذا? Because believing in Allah is that which is the asl, is the foundation. It is what is sought. Right? Believing in Allah is what is sought. And this was the foundation, the asl. After that, believing in the malaika. Why? Because the malaika, they are the intermediary between Allah and his creation. Right? And after that, believing in the books. So the malaika, they will receive the revelation, right, the books. And then we believe in the prophets. So the malaika, they will they will take the revelation from Allah, right? And they will, meaning the revelation, they will take it from Allah. And they will transmit it to the prophets. So that shows barakallah, to the messengers and the prophets, that shows barakallah fikum, the tartib, the sequence is very important. Imam Ahmed rahimahullah, we'll read the bab, and inshallah we'll suffice ourselves with this. And we already pray, inshallah. Wa min as-sunnah.
Did you say the next lesson was again?
That's al-imanu bil-qadari khayrihi wa sharrihi. Believing in the decree, in the predestination, the good and the bad. Wa fikum barakallah. ومن السنة اللازمة التي من ترك منها خصلة لن يقبلها لم يقبلها ويؤمن بها لم يكن من أهلها. الإيمان بالقدر خيره وشره والتصديق بالأحاديث فيه والإيمان بها لا يقال لما ولا كيف، إنما هو التصديق والإيمان بها. Imam Ahmad rahimahullah mentioned, he said, from those aspects of the religion that is lazima, that is binding, that is a must to be there, binding. From those points, he said that anybody that abandoned those points, he said, لَمْ يَقْبَلُهَا, or he doesn't accept it. وَيُؤْمِنُ بِهَا, or he doesn't believe in those points among the binding points. He said, لَمْ يَكُنْ مِنْ أَهْلِهَا, he will not be from the people of it. Meaning from the believers. From the believers. If a person rejected the Qadr, are we going to say he's a believer? And he say, what is that point? He say, al-Imanu bil-Qadr. One of those is believing in the pre-decree or in the predestination. Khayrihi wa sharrihi. The good and the bad. What tasdiqu, and to hold the ahadith that came in regard to that to be the truth. Wal imanu biha, and to believe in it. And la yuqal, it is not to be said. Lima, why? Wala kayfa, how? In regard to the decree of Allah, these two questions is not to be asked. Why and how? But rather, innama huwa. In regard to the belief of the Qadr, it is at-tasdiqu. To hold it to be the truth, to affirm it. وَالْإِيمَانُ بِهَا, and to believe in it. And to believe in it. So from the aspects of the religion, you have those that if an individual abandons it, or he doesn't accept it, or he doesn't believe it, he is not from the believers. And one of them, as Imam Ahmad himself mentioned, الْإِيمَانُ بِالْقَدَرِ خَيْرِهِ وَشَرِّهِ, believing in the pre-decree or the predestination, the good of it and the bad of it. التَصْدِيقُ وَالتَصْدِيقُ بِالْأَحَادِيثِ, and not only that, but also to affirm and agree and hold the ahadith that came with it or that came about it to be the truth. وَالْإِيمَانُ بِهَا, and to believe in them. And it is not that we say lima, why? Wala kaifa, how? So if we don't say why and how, then what will be our position? Our position is at-tasdiqu wal-imanu biha. It is to affirm it, hold it to be the truth, and to believe it firmly. Wa sallallahu wa sallam ala Muhammadin wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. If there was any mistake that I have made, please rectify me. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one that is free from any imperfection, rectify you in your affairs. Ahsan Allah ilaykum. We already pray, Aisha, inshallah. Ahsan Allah ilaykum. Thank you.